Hello, welcome to Age of Wonders Planetfall. And this is just the archives, you don't want to bother with that. And as you can see, the artwork is pretty good for the game, and in case you're wondering why I'm playing the game, it's because of the turn-based combat. Other than that, as you can see, the races are pretty diverse. So in order to really feel the game out, I'll show you the heroes that will make you decide if you like the game or not. I mean, these are the races available to you. So the assembly is just a race of cyborgs. Close quarter specialist, veterans, and of course data repository. The vanguard, which is more like the martial tradition, so they're like the soldiers of the galaxy, and they use firearms and laser weapon groups. Very interesting group in my opinion. But then you have the syndicate with the arc and psi weapons. As you can see, you see what the arc weapons are. And besides, this is just the hero customization. You can see a lot of them. The cyborg, the scholar, and a lot of different things. They start with different loadouts. So this is the Amazon. They are basically bioweapon specialists. Oh, and that will be interesting to see. And laser, and of course, forest affinity and some other things. Yeah, Amazons. These are the bugs, swarm shields, protect units in combat. Rapid growth, Psy and Bio, of course. A Trax rifle, biochemical damage, a Psy Stone of Dissonance. So they also have some grenades. By the way, they look amazing. The creatures, they look just amazing in this game. And you don't know if this is armor or if this is their natural carapace. Some of it is armor, of course. Let's just see some other beautiful creations, and this... just look at them, they are angry space dwarfs. Firearms, explosive, they like mountains, of course. And another part of the assembly, so most of them are very, very random. Regarding their construction, as you can see, this one is more of the humanoid type, but still a little disturbing. Yep, still disturbing, so let's switch to the vanguard. Just normal humans. Oh, this guy knows what's up. He has a lot of armor. Space Fleet Command, right? Just look at this guy. The dwarves are so amazing. I'll just call them dwarves. Because they're also named Dvar or Dwarves or whatever. Everyone knows what they are. And this guy has a beard. A beard armor of hoses. I don't know how to call it. And look at this guy. This guy is even more menacing. He's like a Terminator from space, a small one. And as you can see, the bugs are pretty thin, and sometimes they have a predator thing going on with talons and such. The Amazonians mostly look the same with their bioskin, tight bioskin suits or whatever they are. Well, this one looks a bit more imposing. Now let's go to the last one, because these are the ones that are actually very, very cool. Yeah, this robot seems straight off out of Alita Battle Angel. Okay, enough of that now, because I don't want you to get bored. Let's start a new campaign. The campaign, of course, starts with a tutorial.
The currents of the void shift around me. Follow my voice, my last possession. My name was Empress Carminia, and I was the last regent of the Star Union. We built a paradise on 1,000 planets, a glistening web strung between the stars. But the cataclysm shattered all, leaving our people stranded and alien to one another. Whoever you are, whatever you have become, it is time to leave this dark age behind and return to the worlds of your ancestors. Uncover our secrets, but heed our mistakes. Forge a new empire, a new Age of Wonders.
Sure, let's destroy the galaxy together, right? As you can see, you have a difficulty setting, and the first one is of course a tutorial, so let's see how it is on Expert. This is the Vanguard. You start off with assault equipment. Military detachment, because why not? And yeah, expert, you can customize him. This is your campaign character, so yeah. Expert, let's start the mission.
Commander's personal record. Vanguard LCVP-86 emerged from void space intact. Our destination is a small planet located near to the anomaly in the system. Scans are showing nothing but static from the research outpost below. The distress call we received remains the only sign of life.
Okay, let's start. Spaceship
the void
time.
Anomaly looms over the planet like a dark omen. These scientists must have been mad to study the phenomenon from this close. But it's not for me to question their motives. We're here to secure a foothold, search for any survivors, and investigate what happened. Prepare for planetfall.
I guess this is the anomaly, and this is the planet. A tiny planet, right? Tiny. So let's start the game out. You start with the army and some basic units, but the artwork is just incredible.
Welcome, Commander. I am Ava, your autonomous...
Sure you are. You are Ava. Just follow what they say.
This is an army. Are to move an army, select it. Heroes are special
Of course they are. So let's change the sniper rifle again. These are your resources and your resource production. Cosmite. Void. Oh, that's knowledge, Cosmite and... anyway. That will need... Cosmite and some energy. Now we have a sniper rifle.
Mods allow you to improve your...
No mods yet, so let's just begin researching. Oh, they don't let me do
this
that.
This is the colony interface. Under this colony's name, you can see the amount of each resource this colony generates. A description and a breakdown of the colony's income can be found. The currently selected colony tab is unit production. All units available for construction.
Yes, it is.
This is the structure production tab. Colony structures can be built from here.
And this is how you generate production, a lot of production. This is plus 85. And with this thing you can generate how much more? 15. Yeah, it's recommended. Let's
units
produce
and structures
it.
Can be built and the sector production tab.
We don't need anything else because we already have our army. And a big sniper rifle. So again, this is more like a hero type unit. And each of them have a lot of different stuff to them. For example, he has steady aim, resurgent, some improved overwatch.
This is the unit panel where all the information units can have different roles.
Yes, I know. So these are the backbones, this is the backbones of your army, the backbones, yeah. And they look pretty cool to be honest, just look at their huge rifles, yeah, these are the Space Marines, at least in this universe. So let's move already.
When all suggested actions from the tab...
But I already queued that up. It's queued up.
The task notifier.
Okay, we did all those things. The game wants to leave me alone. Let's end the turn. Now we can start research from the second.
Welcome to the research center, Commander. Here we allocate knowledge to rediscover the technologies of the Star Union and search for new frontiers.
So her tier is locked behind perks, that's okay.
Military research concerns unit unlocks, unit mods, and military operations.
Secret technology perks, okay.
Society research concerns economic development, governmental policies, and espionage.
Doctrine, steer empire economy, and operation research. Well, that's interesting, so let's focus on this one. It will cost you 100 knowledge, but it will be better, right? But yeah, let's go for military and night support. Which will unlock a lot of mods for us. And now let's fight. Let's see the turn-based combat of the game. Attack, minions. So yeah, they actually did the turn-based combat pretty good. I mean, I'm surprised they did it.
The battle has started, Commander. During a combat turn, commanders and heroes.
They did it as good as this. So you have free action points that you can use for movement and attacking. Since this sniper rifle has a good range, I think we can hit them.
A friendly unit.
Oh, it requires a full action, so the assault rifle only needs one action to be shot.
Each unit has try moving your units for.
Okay, game, I understand. I know what I'm doing. So you can also put
some
them
units with range
in Overwatch. So as long as you don't go in the raid area, you can also do the Overwatch. So that's important to know. Okay guys, set up your fire line and wait for the enemy to come to us, right? And this is a speed bike. By the way, you can shoot at your own people if you wanted. Don't worry, the game will let you do anything you want, even if it's a silly thing to do. Out of range, defensive mode, okay, let's end our turn. Yeah, whatever, I don't care. And these are ranged units, of course. Shoot them with
most
a sniper.
Abilities that are used.
Yes. We missed. Let's get closer. I want to hit them. So you can hit them with your weapon, of course. Shoot your weapon or grenades. Yeah, let's stagger them.
A unit has been staggered.
So staggered means they can no longer overwatch and they're no longer guarding and they also lose one action point out of their total of three. So yeah, let's make them lose all their points. Yeah, you can do anything about that. Once per combat, so that's pretty nice. So again, this is a bit of a cheesy tactic, but hey. This is just overwhelming your enemies, right? I mean, the damage difference is not so high sometimes. Yeah, so as you can see, this thing has a lot of movement. Can you shoot at them? Yeah, shoot at them. You missed. They have a ranged attack and also they blow up when they're killed because of their acid speed. Beetle speed. First in bio damage and also applying poison. Yeah, a lot of bad things, so avoid them.
Units with melee attacks. A unit attacked from the sides or back is considered flanked and takes increased damage. Units in guard mode cannot be flanked.
So there is also flanking, which is a nice thing, of course. So yeah, maybe the sniper rifle is not so good. I should give him the other rifle. Can you kill them?
Enemy neutralized.
Nice shot. So let's get out of their way. I don't want to be poisoned by acid. And if you move out of their way, as you can see, that will cause an overwatch attack. Because melee is always activated. So yeah, it's like a zone. Shoot them. Look at the bullets fly out of their rifles. You can also play from this perspective if you want.
Enemy killed. Our forces are victorious.
We won the combat.
Objective completed.
Yeah, you get the reward, and you can also go here
planets
with your army.
Are divided into geographical sectors usually have both to make your
and the next. As you can see, you have some location here which will increase your resources. So let's annex it. Don't worry, they're basically saying we need to kill the bugs, and they are from this planet. The people that have been investigating that phenomenon. Now, this is a tiny map, as you can see. But it's still pretty big, right? Okay, let's stop doing that, because that's addictive. That's addictive almost. Now let's see, they want me to annex this province, which will be completed in one turn. Production cone. Yeah, you can also do a lot of things. Let's start our society research with the facilities. Anything you want me to do?
No. You have just annexed a sector, and it can now be exploited for one of the main resources. Ideally, the chosen exploitation type matches the terrain and climb features of the sector.
Agriculture will be the best one. That will be done in 2 turns. If we have the production for it, that is.
Objective completed.
Also, we unlocked the nanite support. Don't worry about it, let's just put that.
Our colonies.
So this is for more food or more sector research. Again, I'll go deeper into these things after I start the real campaign, since this is only the tutorial. I'm not liking that thing. 16, 90 and 10. So what's the difference between the laser rifle and the assault rifle? So this does fire damage, that does ballistic damage. Yeah, let's use that one. Grenades or the revolver, yeah. If you use the laser one, you can also have fire damage and impact damage. Now let's see, flechette ammo. Well, I guess I can't use it because it's a laser type, so... Yeah, let's switch to the assault rifle, repeating. Yeah, looks a lot more interesting right now. Flechette ammunition that can inflict bleeding. Also the nanite. So what do the incinerators do? So we have a chance to set them on fire. I guess I prefer the ballistic weapons more. And you can do this for all your units. For example, just give them the nanite injector. And you can give this to all the units in here.
Once mods have been assigned to a unit, a new template needs to be made for the modified unit.
Okay. So that means they can basically regenerate at will. And this has a lot of lasers on it. So we can produce it straight up with those mods. Okay, now let's defeat the hoppers over there, and you'll actually receive some help. I won't stay too long in the tutorial area, believe me. I just want to show you the basic stuff.
When engaging an army in combat, all armies adjacent to the defending army that are allied to...
Yes, so we'll basically engage the combat with 2 groups. And that will be amazing because we'll shoot them from a lot of directions. And they'll actually come to us because they will jump on us. That's why they're called hoppers. And you know, those bugs, they'll spit at us. And they'll die in a vicious explosion of acid. Okay, let's prepare for the worst. To be honest, I think we can skip the first turn. Nothing really happens in here, but I can show you the engineers, which can deploy a turret. Hey, engineers, deploy the turret. And they have shotguns, of course, because they are engineers, why not? Overwatch. And she's also a sniper unit, the lady who's the new hero. Now let's end the turn. As I said, you don't do much of anything in the first turn. You can set up your overwatch so you hit them. That was great. You should use overwatch,
after the
but...
first round of combat,
operations ready.
25, so yeah, you can also use these things. Tactical operations. But that will cost you energy, of course, and some points. I don't know how you regenerate those points, but let's just use this thing. Oh, I forgot, you have to click right click. So that also staggered them, so now we can just shoot them at will. Oh, the grenade range is actually pretty short, so you have to shoot them again. Yeah, I like how that looks. Oh, can we kill them now? No, we can't. Let's soften them up a bit more. Yeah, this looks amazing in my opinion. And now we can kill them with our mighty hero, right? Mighty hero, kill them.
Enemy annihilated.
That's why I like it. I like it so much. Killing aliens with spaceship troopers or whatever you want to call them. To be honest, I want to destroy this thing first. Because it does a lot, it creates so many problems for you. 20. I guess this is the same thing, but that has an area of effect. Oh, that was a vicious blow to them. Yeah, let's attack them. That's a great because we are so far away. And as you can see, this will automatically end our turn. So I didn't spend my many action points, but enough to shoot them. Oh, now it's time to have more fun. So that unit will be left alive. That's barely alive, so let's shoot this with the big guns. Engineers are so cool, man. Just so cool. Okay, guys, come over here. And shoot them. Actually, let's soften them up before you do that. Maybe a grenade? Yeah, a grenade would be more useful. Okay, now use your shotguns and we'll finish them with the hero. Yeah, but they mean business. Just look at their suits. That was a nice shot, right? Hurry up, man. Let's stagger them some more because I don't want them to have any action points next turn, and I also want to eliminate some cover. Oh, by the way, we're just destroying tents, nothing important, right? Just a few tents along the way. So yeah, the humans are pretty powerful as you can see.
Enemy down.
That was a nice sniper shot. Yes, let's end the turn. They flanked the bike, so watch out for that. And they spit on the bike.
Enemy neutralized.
That one died because it was burning. Sadly, you can order multiple troops to shoot at it, but let's just kill it the old-fashioned way. Oh, that one missed. Let's finish them off with our hero unit. Do your thing, Mr. Hero.
Enemy eliminated. They never stood a chance.
No, they didn't. Okay, nothing too important to read, believe
Objective
me.
Objective completed.
We have to go there. This is the colony building thing. Just move it to the central point and just make a colony over there. Gravitonic wave, what? It looks like we're still holding on to our atom. Status report. The void anomaly absorbed most of the gravitonic force, keeping the planet relatively unaffected. Yeah. Something weird is happening here. And that is not ready currently. The colony is ready here.
Objective completed.
As you can see, this still has a little production left. It can produce science, production, food, energy, and of course specialized training centers. The bike, the Vanguard Pug, which sounds amazing. Or the dome for more happiness and great events, where it can just generate energy. So let's pretend we know what we are doing and... Where is that thing? Now let's see, what does this thing do? So it has an agricultural exploitation, which means it gets extra food. So that's an objective completed. Basically now we just have to conquer the rest of the map, but to be honest, I just want to end the mission. This is a very short mission, and it only teaches you the basic of the gameplay. You will learn the rest, don't worry. Okay, the Voitech facility to be annexed, so we also have to annex this thing. And this is a really important resource tier.
Landmarks are remnants of powerful star union structures. There are three kinds of landmarks: bronze, silver, and gold, with increasing economic value.
As you can see, this will give us energy, population, and production. This is a very important one. And we also unlock the Rift Generator. So yeah, let's annex it, because we built this colony next to this one, just so we can annex this one. Oh, let's close that, and then we have to wait one turn. Also, let's set the production for here, and let's just make a sustained trooper, right? And over here, let's make another trooper. Just because the game will warn you if you don't do something. There is a 99% chance that the planet will be consumed by the anomaly within the next 3 cycles, which means very soon. Yeah, there is no time to waste. Yeah. Due to void disturbance, there is a 33% chance of catastrophic failure during gravity well escape. This is bad. Yeah, we'll die if we remain here. Lock in the escape vectors and get out. Okay, let's just go. Let's just leave. We won the mission, thankfully, and it's only 30 minutes long.
We barely escaped the surface of the planet before the void anomaly consumed it. We're lucky to have gotten the colonists out alive. These last few days have left me filled with more questions than answers. What happened on the surface here? What was that gravitronic wave that ripped through this star cluster?
We have no idea, but we'll find out.
Well, it looks like we'll have plenty of time to sleep on this. The gravitronic force destabilized the void rift in this system, making faster than light travel impossible. We have to get home the old-fashioned way, will take us close to 200 years to reach the nearest Star Union hub. I have ordered everyone to prepare for cryosleep. We will see what kind of world we wake up to.
Yeah, we'll just sleep for 200 years and then we'll wake up in a better world, I'm sure of it. No more wars, no more nothing. And this is the second mission. I mean, you completed the tutorial and as you can see... Is this a new... Oh, so this is a new campaign planet, right? So I guess we're just continuing this campaign and we have other campaigns to complete. But we'll see that in the next video. See you soon, Space Cowboys. Bye!